They said Rahul Madan here is a chief executive officer of Treasury Consulting PT Limited, which is a Singaporean multinational group. And today we are going to cover a very dedicated topic, which is on the hedge accounting of a commodity, which is known as corn. So basically we are covering a commodity which is quite common in US and European market. We are covering a commodity which have a little presence in India as well. A commodity which you will find there are a lot of takers, which as far as the US is concerned and so on and so forth. In this we are talking about an exchange which is CBOT, which is Chicago Board of Trade. We are going to be covering about how you would be able to do the hedge accounting of that commodity, which is known as corn. Now the type of corn which we are going to be using is the ZCN8. I repeat, it is ZCN8. This is the commodity which we are using. Now there are a few things which we need to remember before we are going for a commodity, before we go for hedge accounting. Most of the people do not understand the technical meaning of hedge accounting. Technically speaking, hedge accounting is the ability whereby you would be able to put forward the mark-to-market gain losses in balance sheet, not in the P&L. Because the purpose of the company is to do the business. The purpose of the company is not to do is not to take the gains and losses of the derivatives into the P&L unless otherwise the relevant commodity is a freestanding position. Now there is a difference if there is an exposure. So actually there are three kind of scenarios which you have in the hedge accounting. Technically speaking, four. One is the freestanding, when there is no exposure. So according to the internet, there are 95% of the transactions which are happening in the future, including oil, they are freestanding in nature, whereby people are taking the position and before F&D, which is the first notice day, they would cancel the position. But it's not cancellation basically, what they do, they will take an alternate position. So if they are on the sell side, they will take on the buy side and so on and so forth. Another which people do have, they have a forecasted position, which is genuine in nature. Genuine in the sense like there is a company who is using a corn to make any material. Example, they are using the corn in making biscuits or maybe any other kind of FMCG material. And they forecasted that there is a great requirement of a corn that is coming because the demand is rising. Let's take an example of Hindustan Unilever Limited, ITC. There are multiple FMCG related groups we have across the globe who are producing a huge amount of FMCG related quantity. If they foresee the great expansion in their demand, although they are not pretty sure about it, they can create a forecasted transaction. Of course, the major benefit of forecasted versus the freestanding is that in case the forecast do not turn right, so assuming you did estimate that you would have 1 million order of biscuit packets, assuming, and you are using the same kind of corn here, which is ZCNS, and assuming your forecast went not well and you would be able to end up only 900k, so 100k is more. In that sense, what you do, you will reverse the rest, which is 100k, and you're still in a profitable position. One is when you have an exposure. Now what do you mean by an exposure? Exposure means like Hindustan Unilever Limited, ITC, or the multiple like Nestle. Like Nestle is a coffee maker, although we are talking about a corn, but just let's take an example. You know, Nestle is pretty sure that this much amount of commodity they are using every month from the last 10 years. Like Nestle is producing Maggi, they are producing a lot of different vegetable items. Assuming they are using this corn in that, and they are sure that in the last 10 years they are consuming this much level of corn in their products, so they are sure about it. This is nothing but exposure. And please be note that corn is being measured, which is in bushels. I repeat, another very important which is last is that which is either EFP, exchange for physicals, EFS, exchange for swaps. So although there are multiple, so there are four ways the hedge accounting is measured. Actually, one way of one way by hedge accounting is coming, which is freestanding. Please be note that when it comes to freestanding, everything will go in the P&L. So you need not to be worried. You cannot mitigate the impact of P&L. As simple as that. Another thing which is there, once it is forecasted in nature. Please be note that in forecasted, there are two legs. Now, let me write here, which is the fair valuation of hedged item. And let me write here, fair valuation of hedging derivative. Now, in a freestanding, fair value of hedged item will not exist, do not exist, while the fair valuation of derivatives will enter the P&L. On the contrary, in a forecasted transaction, the fair value of hedged item do not exist, but it will go to OCI provided it is effective in nature. If it is not effective in nature, it will move to P&L. In case of the direct exposure like Nestle, which is a leading giant as far as the FMCG products are concerned, they know that from the last several years or since inception or maybe so many years, they are consuming this much amount of the quantity. In that sense, what Nestle exactly is doing, Nestle is taking an exposure. In this, the fair value of hedged item, you know, it will hit your balance sheet, and it would also hit the balance sheet provided it is effective in nature. Fourth is exchange for physicals. On the contrary, exchange for swaps. This is a little technical which we are not covering now. But exchange for physical and exchange for swaps is nothing but the sum of exposure plus the exchange for physical or exchange for swap. Now, one component is exposure, which I told you. Now, please be note that before taking into hedge accounting, I would like to introduce you a few important concepts here. Of course, we will make a separate video for that. There are a lot of people, a lot of apprehensions about hedge accounting, and there are a lot of apprehensions about the dollar offset method. Although we are not here discussing in detail what dollar offset is all about, we already have a video about that. There is a lot of apprehension about regression method and so on and so forth. Unfortunately, people start creeping, and there are a lot of people who creep that dollar offset is not turning effective in nature. But these people do not know that dollar offset will never be effective unless you are using a rolling or regular hedging programs. If as a company you are using an ad hoc hedging program, so there are a lot of companies, I do not want to mention the name of the company in India, but this is in an aviation sector. I hope you may guess this company was in news. But this company is predominantly on the ad hoc hedging program. They do not have a standard hedging program in place. There are a lot of multinational groups which I know, without quoting the name, they are also on the ad hoc hedging program. If you are on the ad hoc hedging program and you're expecting that you will get the effectiveness, your hedge effectiveness testing would be effective in nature, this would never happen. You have to go for hedging programs. How will you go for hedging programs? Now, how will you go for hedging programs? You first need to understand there are multiple types of hedging programs which we have. One is known as rolling monthly hedging. One is known as rolling quarterly hedging. One is known as rolling yearly hedging. Now, as you very well understand that, we have different type of underlying as far as the hedging is concerned. Let us take a small detour here and let's talk about currency. We have a lot of companies like Infosys, Wipro, TCS, SCL and other. How do we know why these companies are always spot neutral? So Indian rupee went to 62, now it is approximately 68.20, and it was a time when it did went to 68.80 also, but IT companies are always spot neutral in nature because they are using the rolling hedging program. So without quoting the name of the IT company, we have one IT company who is on the rolling monthly. We have one IT, number of IT companies which are rolling quarterly. We have rolling yearly also. When we talk about two commodities which are not only volatile in nature, but they are extremely volatile in nature, this is nothing but oil and CNG, oil and natural gas. About oil and natural gas, people are saying in the market that they are the commodities where cracks can go anywhere. Like talking today, which is 26th of June, the cracks are getting narrow. The reason being, the input material is rising, the oil prices are falling. In fact, the spread between Brent and the WTI is also getting narrow, which used to be pretty wide. Now the moral of the story is, if you coming in the market on an ad hoc note and you hedge your position only because things are going in a very upward direction, and you are thinking that you will get the effectiveness testing of that, then my apologies, you will never get it. So we, while doing a hedge effectiveness testing, we need to understand that we should have an appropriate hedging program in place. Unfortunately, majority of the people even do not know what is rolling hedging program, and that is why they are losing a handsome amount of money. Another very important thing which I wanted to deliberate today, which is OHLC cycle. Open high, low close. You must be thinking this is not a technical analysis. Now, O means open high, low close. Whenever you are booking a rate, now unfortunately in the books we refer this as a deal rate and so on and so forth. But the technical meaning is the dealt rate. Now the treasury department of a relevant company should be efficient enough to deal with the dealt rate. Which rate I am going to be taking? Now let me write here. I am going to be taking open, I am taking high, I am taking low, or I am taking close. Which rate I am going to be taking in nature? We need to appreciate one fact very carefully, that the treasury department should be able to understand first of all where you are. Are you on the buy side or are you on the sell side? And if you are on the buy side, where to go? If you are on the sell side, where to go? This is a dealt rate. There is a specific reason to it. Majority of the ineffectiveness come because of the dealt rate. Example, I have saw several companies, those who are hedging here, and they are on the sell side. Now once they will get the rate which is known as mark to market rate, they would always be ineffective in nature. Why they would be ineffective in nature? The answer is quite simple. Because you dealt at a low rate, market is on the high side, you would always be ineffective in nature. Now the last thing in this video is, when we talking about a hedge accounting, because this is part 1. In the part 2 we will move to dollar offset. When you are talking about the hedge accounting, you should always talk about which methodology you are using in mark to market. Are you using level 1, you're using level 2, you're using level 3, or you're using level 4. Unfortunately, most of the people in the companies believe that mark to market is nothing but the difference between the forward rate and the rate at which you have taken a position, or nothing but the derivative position minus the live spot rate. Excuse me, boss. L1, L2, L3 and L4, which is FS-133, Financial Accounting Standard 133, 157 US GAAP, IFRS 7913, which is IFRS, IS 39 and IS 3032. There are all three different accounting standards, IND AS 109. All three are supporting level 1, level 2, level 3. Now level 1 means mark to market. Level 2 means level 1 means mark to market. Level 2 means mark to matrix. Level 3 means mark to model. Level 4 means mark to margin. Don't take it lightly. Once you are taking a position, you should know that you are at L1, L2, L3 or L4. Even if you are taking a position in the oil, you are taking a position in the CNG and all, you should quite aware of the fact that where you stands, and then you will go accordingly. This is for the today. The next video which we would be doing on the hedge accounting of the corn, we would be talking about how you can use the dollar offset method and what are the various precautions that you should be taking while doing the dollar offset method. In case you're left with any question, you're most welcome to contact us 9899242978. My Skype is Rahul5327. My email is rahul.magan@treasuryconsulting.in, while our platform is www.fixedincome.global and our website is www.treasuryconsulting.in. There are multiple videos on the way. See you soon. Thank you. Have a wonderful time ahead. Thank you.